In the night from January 19 to 20, Soviet troops entered Baku and nearby regions, massacring the civilian population using heavy military equipment and other various forms of weaponry. The Soviet army deployed a large contingent of special and internal troops in Baku, who displayed unprecedented cruelty against the peaceful population. More than 100 civilians were killed, and 744 more were wounded.
İlham and Farize Allahverdiyev's wrote a story of heroism and love with their deaths. Like Ilham, Farize also participated in the protests of the independence movement across the city. This tragic night, Ilham was running near the tanks and shouting to the soldiers not to shoot. But the soldiers opened fire, and one of the first victims was Ilham.
When his wife Farize heard that Ilham had died, she committed suicide.
Sahip Hasanov was 40 years old. When he was going to work, the soldiers shot his car. One of the bullets touched his forehead. After the tank crashed the rear of the car, it was thrown to the side of the road. He had 8 gunshot wounds.
Ilkin Javanshirov was 56 years old and he had 9 children. He worked as taxi driver, and then he heard about Soviet armies entering Baku. He went to help people for saving their lives. While he was bringing wounded people to the hospital, he was shot by soldiers.
Vafadar Eminov was the student of law faculty of the Baku State University. After examination session, he went to hospital for giving blood to wounded people, was shot when he went out of the hospital.
Abulfaz Jafarov was 23 years old. When he was coming to the city center of Neftchala, he was a witness of evidence that how people were killed and tortured. His last words were, "God, I'm dying for my motherland and my people."
Ruslan Allahverdiyev was one of the young victims of this tragedy. He was 22 years old. He was killed by 2 bullets.
Zahid Abdullayev was 30 years old. He worked in a factory and he had 3 children. He received a gunshot wound to his head.
Bala Hussein Hamzaev was 61-year-old grandfather who was killed by 3 bullets on the night of 19 January while he was protecting his 5 children on the Surakhana roadway.
Habil Azizov was 22-year-old university student. He came to Baku to give his semester exam. Unfortunately, Habil was killed on his birthday night, January 19, under an enemy tank.
Vladimir Tokarev, 36-year-old man, was also one of those who was killed while protecting a child during that tragic night.
Teymur Almamadov was 17-year-old student and was killed by 2 bullets when he was buying a ticket to go back home to Nakhchivan. Unfortunately, Teymur never reached his home.
Yuri Binyatzade, 20-year-old student and a player, was one of the youngest victims of this tragic night. He matched eyes while he crossed the pass of the Soviet army, which was entering Baku.
Rima Hussainov was one of the youngest victims of Black January. He was just a 15-year-old youngster when he was killed. He was the only son of his family.
Shakir Aghachiev, a 29-year-old man, was a victim of the Soviet army. He was killed while protecting his nephew. He was shot 5 times. He had 2 children when he died, and his little son was born after his death.
aslına kadar when all the young people stood in a row in front of soldiers to protect women and old people. They were shot mercilessly by soldiers.
Larisa Mamadova was a 12-year-old schoolgirl. That night, she was on a bus with her father. The bus came under fire, and one of the many bullets shot Larisa straight through the heart.
Jabrail Khamamadov. My grandfather was 50 years old and had 4 children. When he heard about the crackdown, he couldn't stay at home. He was killed by 5 of the 6 gunshots.
At that time, Heydar Aliyev was living in Moscow. He came to Azerbaijan's permanent representation and extended his condolences to the people of Azerbaijan. In his speech, he emphasized that the initiators of the tragedy were then officials of the USSR, and they had done nothing to calm the people down. Heydar Aliyev, who considered this tragedy a crime against the Azerbaijani people, emphasized that the perpetrators bore responsibility for it and should properly be punished.
Пришел сюда прежде всего для того, чтобы здесь впоследствии, который является небольшим куском азербайджанской земли в Москве, выразить свое соболезнование всему азербайджанскому народу в связи со случившейся трагедией большими жертвами. И, во-вторых, высказать свое отношение. Теперь, что касается событий, которые произошли в Азербайджане. Я их считаю антиправными, антидемократичными, полностью противоречащими принципам гуманизма. Но при всех обстоятельствах я считаю, что были возможности для политического урегулирования вопроса, были возможности для диалога с народом, но они не были использованы. И в ночь с 19 на 20 в Баку были введены крупные контингенты советской армии и войск МВД СССР. И что, к чему это привело? Каким трагическим последствиям это привело, теперь уже хорошо нам известно. Я думаю, что те люди, которые приняли такое решение, я считаю, что политически ошибочное, допущена грубая политическая ошибка, они просто не знали подлинной обстановки в республике, психологию азербайджанского народа, они не имели достаточных контактов с различными слоями людей и не могли представить себе, что дело обернется такой трагедией.
The first political legal recognition of January 20 tragedy came on March 29, 1994, when Azerbaijan's legislative body, Milli Meclis, adopted a relevant resolution upon the initiative of the national leader, Heydar Aliyev. According to the decree of the President of the Republic of Azerbaijan, all victims of the tragedy were awarded an honorary title of the Martyr of January 20. Despite the bloody events in Baku, the day of January 20, 1990, became a page of heroism in the history of struggle for independence and territorial integrity of Azerbaijan.